Do you hate jungles? Well then avert your eyes, cause that's what we're making today. Quick disclaimer, this video is not for beginners by any stretch of the imagination. It's more of a workflow than a tutorial anyway. So if you're totally new to Blender, I recommend researching particle systems and materials. Let's go. Alright, so first things first, we need to add a ground plane. And last time I checked, the jungles aren't flat, so we'll just need to turn on proportional editing and adjust this to taste. That's good enough. Alright, so we'll need to add a camera, because how else will we be able to see anything? And we don't want this horizon to just fall off into nothingness, so we're going to duplicate this plane a few times, just to get some background. We don't need to go too crazy into the modeling, just because this is going to be, you know, disappear behind smoke and mirrors. I lied. It's actually just smoke that it's going to disappear behind. Alright, so I added a layer of displacement onto my planes, just to add a little extra layer of depth goodness, and did that to all of them. Let's add a material to this bad boy. So I have a really basic repeating ground pattern of just like dirt and leaves, like a mossy, planty, dirt leaf base, and I applied this to all of these. And if we give that a render, we can see how it looks. Okay, this is good, this is looking horrible. Now let's add some shrubs to kick things up a notch. Let's add another plane. And this one we're going to turn into a leaf. So we need to unwrap it onto this leaf image, it's an alpha image. You can make your own, or you can find something of the likeness for free online, like CG textures. So where I got this piece of digital real estate. Adjust the size to your liking. After we make sure it's a material, we're going to make this a translucent material. That way the light can pass through it and look a little more lifelike. Now we're going to hook up the materials, add a transparency node, add a mix node, attach the alpha to the mix, and then we should be getting something. Now you're gonna make this shaped a little more like a leaf. Arch it up, add a smooth shading, and then we're going to just duplicate this. You know what they say. Why do this a ton of times? What you can do it just one time. You can scale it up and adjust it and make it just a little more random. Then make sure it's all one object. Onto the foreground ground, I just added a particle system of the bush we just made. Make sure the scale is to your liking. And let's see how it's going. So you see we got something natural going on here. I mean, it kind of looks like a farm. A leaf farm. But last time I checked, we're not leaf farmers. Let's fix this boring background once and for all, shall we? So I did the same thing I just did for the leaves, except this time I did it with trees. And I just added a particle system of the planes onto the trees. You can find these also on CG textures to make like a pseudo forest. And let's see how this looks. This is looking pretty spectacular. I mean, as you can see, the seam between the foreground and the background is seamless. These little bushes blend right into the big trees. I mean, you could post this online right now and be proud of it. No one's noticing it yet. You know what? We might need to give it a little kickstart. There is no shame in liking your own stuff. So now we need some palm trees, and if you're like me and you like stealing other people's work, you can just download a palm tree instead of modeling one. Something like BlendSwap will probably have something amazing. So I found this one. It is a group of palm trees, so that's handy. I was going to credit the maker of it, but it seems like he totally disappeared, like after I downloaded it. Like, I'm not even joking. I couldn't re-find him, and I couldn't find the same palm tree. But there are other ones like it that you can use. So, sorry, mystery man out there. If you're watching this, you know, you can be proud that your work is being used. You know what you did. And the only thing I did was I changed the leaves to be translucent, because it was just a plain old diffuse. Added another particle system into the foreground, and let's see how that's looking. Now, we need something in between, like another level of shrubbery. But, you know, we already have, like, one shrub. And we have these trees, which are basically shrubs on sticks. So I say, let's just get rid of the stick and repurpose somebody else's work, what we already have. So if we delete the bottom half of that, we have basically a whole new plant. So the only thing I did with this one was I changed the color, the tint of the color slightly, so that it's a little less yellow-green and a little more to the blue-green, just to vary things up a little more. And we can see how that looks. This is not too shabby. We're really making grounds. So let's add some other types of trees. because, you know, this jungle doesn't just survive off of tropical trees, we can do other things. So there's other tutorials out there on using the sapling add-on. I'm not going to get into that. But we'll make a makeshift tree, add a basic wood texture. Let's build something totally different for the leaves to vary it up more. So I'm going to make a branch by adding a box and then extruding parts of it. You know, this is where you really need to bump up your modeling skills to create advanced things like this. So I'm just going to duplicate this a few times and then vary it up because branches aren't flat. So I'm just going to make it thinner. I added another leaf pattern and just put this onto the edges. This has the same transparency that all the other things have. Just kind of duplicate it around, put it on the edges, make it look like a branch, and call this something clever. We're going to take our trees, we're going to add a vertex group. Basically, we're just going to take everything up here and group it. When we add a particle system, make it hair, make it an object, make it the branch. And also set it to the vertex group. That looks like a tree to me. You know what we're going to do? We're also going to add a second particle system. Also make this hair. This is going to be vines. Going to be some vines going down. Tweak the settings to get it to go straight down. You might need to go to advanced. Figure out something from somewhere. This looks promising. Alright, so just do that a lot. So we're going to scatter these evenly and just kind of make sure they're good. I got like this big super tree and then all these baby trees. For the big tree, I sculpted the trunk of it a little bit just to give it a little more shape, but you can adjust to your liking. Also, I'm kind of blending out the seams of the leaves to the background because it looks horrible. I think I actually lost a follower by posting that picture. Because they saw it and thought, this guy is not what I thought he was. The vines, I added a few custom curves just to mix things up a notch and make it look more viney. You know, super, super easy. Just subtle detail adds a lot more texture. And we can see how this looks. Now, something's wrong with that tree. Tree trunks don't grow, like, all exposed like that. So we're going to need to cover it up. You know what, an easy fix for this? Instead of having a particle system up top, just have it cover it all over. Like, just get rid of this. And there you go. That was easy. Let's see how this looks. Alright, so we got it all in there. We need some kind of misty jungle atmosphere to tie this all together. I'm not going to go into detail on this. There's not a lot of details to go into. There's great tutorials out there on how to do fog and haze. Gleb Alexandrov has a great tutorial, which I'll link to right here. So just make a box and then have it like that, and then we'll render that and see how it looks. So you'll definitely need to adjust the contrast and the colors, and that's totally preference, and then get it to where you like it. Before you go, I just need to say this. Our short film, The Optimist, is in a contest right now over at Fandependant Films. It premiered today, May 10th, and it will only be there for 3 weeks. I'll link to it below, but by clicking on that and giving it a view, you will help to support this channel, so please, please, please do that.